Hi, I'm Dave Cotton. Well, for most people, using a credit union or a bank is a normal part of life. But some people use what are called alternative financial institutions like payday lenders and check cashing stores. Sherry Wallace with STCU is here to talk about the trouble with banking off the grid. What percentage of the population is unbanked and why?
So, Dave, a 2015 survey showed that 7% of the U.S. households are unbanked. That's 9 million people. They also found that 20% of households are underbanked, which means they have an account with a bank or a credit union, but they're still using alternative banking services such as the payday lender. And part of the reason for this is that sometimes they just simply don't trust banks, or they're afraid of the fees. They may think they don't have enough money to have an account. But sometimes also, they've been asked to leave an institution because of overdraft history.
Okay, and why is this a bad thing? Obviously, these fees really add up, right?
They do add up. On average, these households are spending $200 to $300 in alternative banking fees.
Wow.
And things such as payday loans, they often cost way more than what the original loan amount was.
So for someone watching this saying, all right, that's all great, what are the benefits of traditional banking?
So traditional banking allows you to establish a rapport and a relationship with your financial institution. Two things come from that. One, you get fair credit prices when you ask for a loan. And two, you develop an income history. So when you're ready to make those large investments like buying a home, you have the history that you need.
Okay, and what's a great way for someone to get, you know, back on the road to being on the grid?
The first thing is I would talk to my friends, family, and colleagues to find out can they recommend a financial institution that might be willing to work with me. And the second thing is the Bank on Spokane program allows you to talk to someone who might connect you with a financial institution willing to work with you. And SNAP also works with the Bank on program that provides financial counseling.
Okay, some great information, and you can get those at a couple different websites we'll show you here. Bankonspokane.org as well as snapwa.org. Sherry, thanks a lot for coming down.
Thank you.